I discovered E.F. Benson through Map and Lucia. I saw the TV series first and then read all the books. Then I found, I suppose I must just through reading around it, discovered that he was most famous in his day, not for Map and Lucia, but for his spook stories, as he called them. Obviously, as an absolute devotee of horror and the supernatural, I then went on to those. I think that there's one called The Room in the Tower, which was always one of my favourites, and it's actually, reading it again, it's actually really creepy. But I think that's what I like about them overall. There are some which are lighter in tone. There's one called Spinach in this collection, which is very much of the Map and Lucia world, fake mediums and much more brittle and camp. But they're mostly quite full of dread, and obviously there are certain preoccupations that must have haunted him through his life, which come out through the books. But I think, The Room in the Tower is probably the creepiest of them. There's a wonderful collection by Roald Dahl, oddly, which he edited, not that he'd written. And the introduction to that book is really terrific because he was commissioned in the 50s to actually produce a series of TV adaptations. So he read hundreds and thousands of them. And the series never happened, but he kept the list of what he thought were the best. So it's a really good list of stuff. Obviously, the master is M.R. James, and quite rightly so. He has a particular, unique take on the whole form. It's always a story that happened about 30 or 40 years ago to a friend of somebody. There's a sort of distance to it, and always a threat usually from the ancient past of some terrible creature or some vengeful spirit. They're my favourites. Agatha Christie, although I've read them all, and that was my required holiday reading when I was a kid. I love mystery books. They're a bugger to write, but they're great fun to read. Just read Michael Block's wonderful biography of Jeremy Thorpe, and another book by Michael Block, which I'm currently reading, I'm tearing through, called Closet Queens, which is it's not as salacious as it sounds. It's actually very learned, but it's a history of 20th century politicians who were closet gay men and some of their really quite extraordinary experiences and how they got away with it. It's amazing. I'm hugely enjoying that at the moment. Well, I'm tired of saying this because I say it in every interview and still no one's rung up. I want to play Jacob Marley in The Christmas Carol, which is my favourite, one of my absolute favourite Dickens and my favourite stories, and I love that character. I've dressed up as him three times for fancy dress. I've actually adapted the thing twice. It's never happened. I'm getting tired of it. I'll be dead before it happens. Then I'll have to come back as a ghost to do it. As a child, I used to rehearse being Marley in the mirror. And my favourite bit, for sheer spookiness. People often forget one of the great things about this story. It's a great ghost story. It's not just a Christmas story or this amazing story that feels like it's been with us forever. It's a great ghost story. And Marley, of course, is the most spook-like of them all. And Scrooge says to him, "Spirit, what do you want with me?" And he says, "Much." I love that.